Welcome to This Just In, the show bringing you the latest advancements in healthcare, strategy, innovation, and public policy. And now, for the fastest voice in healthcare, here's your host, Justin Barnes.
Thank you for tuning in, and welcome to This Just In. I'm your host, Justin Barnes. In these segments, I'll bring you the latest advancements in healthcare, strategy, innovation, and public policy. As always, we're broadcasting from the This Just In studios on the Business Radio X network, as well as the Healthcare Now radio network. For this episode, my 213th episode, we have a very special guest coming to the show, Karen Groppe, Senior Director, Strategic Communications for HIMSS. Welcome to the show, Karen.
Hi, Justin. How are you?
I'm fantastic. Staying warm. But where are you calling in from today?
I am actually calling in from Bethesda, Maryland, which is right outside of Washington, D.C., or I like to say I am one stop away from Dr. Fauci at NIH.
Perfect. I love that. You have a lot of energy right now around you with the upcoming inauguration, all that good stuff. So that's kind of cool.
We've had an exciting, scary, challenging time. I'm a native Washingtonian. So in a sense, this is one of my favorite times of, you know, in the four-year cycle. And then in other sense, it's just been heartbreaking. So.
So you're new to the show. So tell us a little bit about your background and how you made your way to HIMSS.
Well, the way I made my way to HIMSS was through a gentleman named Tom Leary, who's our Senior Vice President of Government Relations.
Love Tom. Great guy. Great gentleman.
Yeah, great guy. Tom actually hired me as a contractor about 6 years ago to help him out with public policy communication.
Sure.
And being in Washington, D.C., it's something I love, and it's something I enjoyed working with Tom. And it just evolved from there. I fell in love with the mission of the organization, fell in love with the staff, and then surrounded by people every day who challenge me and expect me to be the best. So I love it. It's a wonderful, it's a great organization to be a part of. I'm very fortunate with what I'm able to do.
Yes, we must have missed each other by probably just a couple of months. We sold one of my last large companies back in 2014, and I took a little bit of time just to slow down and catch my legs underneath me again. It was a ferocious 13 years, but I spent a lot of time with HIMSS, working with Tom Leary and Dave Roberts, and just through the years, a lot of Capitol Hill strategy in conjunction with HIMSS. And so got to know Tom really well, but the entire HIMSS organization and all of HIMSS leadership. And so, you know, you've joined a phenomenal team, great leaders, and, you know, congratulations. And I'm looking very forward to this show because we're going to talk about HIMSS in 2021. And that's an extremely important piece to healthcare and health IT in America. But also, I know you guys got a lot to share. You've been doing a lot of strategic planning. So let's dive in.
Sure.
Awesome. So tell me, you know, what do you guys have planned for 2021? And I know we'll go through a lot of different components of that, but what are you guys looking forward to this year?
Well, you know, we're here to talk about hope. You know, we have hope to come together in person for HIMSS21 in August. We have hope. That's the key word. You know, what happens in February is going to be a different world in April. There are a lot of things that are out of our control. But with that hope that we're going to be together in person, we also have plans for a digital experience, plans in place and beginning to build for a hybrid experience with the hope of being in person as well as digitally. But the other thing is all of our paths of how we're going to get to an educational networking collaboration experience for our members and for the community is going to be done safely. And it's going to be done successfully.
Excellent. And so specifically, I know that a lot more will be planned, but it's in Las Vegas in August. But what else? I mean, what else? What dates are they again in August for all my guests?
August 9th through the 13th.
Excellent.
And that's, you know, we hope, like I said, so my voice cracked because I'm constantly cheering to my coworkers. It's hope. It's hope. It's kind of like how we cheer with the vaccines. Mm-hmm. Vaccines bring us hope. Kind of same thing, but we're not going to be you know, our the community that attends HIMSS has been on the front line.
Right.
And not only that of our community, but the world we live in. And it has been a devastating year that we've all endured. So it's navigating. We want to move forward, but we want to show respect.
Yeah.
And keep everyone safe. That is at the forefront. Usually the traditional way we announce, you know, our global conference is great fanfare, speakers and invites and sponsorships and sessions. And this year we're going to go a different route.
Well, I'm very hopeful that we will have a mixture of in-person and a phenomenal digital experience. Because I think that would be, that kind of blends, I think, the future of where we're going as well.
We've seen since 20, when everyone's moved to that digital world, we've seen the engagement. We've seen people engaging on online learning. You know, we've seen people begin to network. We see that. And we're excited about that. We're encouraged by that. But then we see the hope that our members have too, and our community has. Justin, we received more than 700 speaker presentations. For an experience. That for us is very exciting.
It's excellent. So obviously a lot evolving here in America, globally, but what are some of the major themes that you see coming for HIMSS? Not only maybe HIMSS in 2021, but certainly annual conference and other events. There's got to be some big themes that you guys are kind of gleaning onto.
Well, we're gonna continue on with Be the Change. And carry that theme through in 21, and probably a little bit more applicable now more than ever is how are we the change individually, collectively? One of the things that we're really excited about, you know, there's a new administration now that our GR team is engaging with, new thoughts, new policies. Those are things we're going to be talking about in 2021. You know, our interoperability team has formed a global consortium to talk about interoperability standards. We're going to look at our maturity models and celebrate those. Our international teams are bringing together communities to further the digital health conversation. So there are those sorts of trends and storylines are bubbling up within the organization. And it's exciting. I think there was a time where when the pandemic was first declared, it was kind of like oh no. but it's carrying on, and it's thanks to our members and our community that are helping us push forward to be the change.
So, bringing up, I know for a fact some of the great relationships that Tom and the government relations team has with the incoming administration, because that's part of a lot of those discussions and communications. 4 to 6, well, even 10, 12 years ago. But I think HIMSS is terrifically positioned because a lot of the names that I've seen bubble up on the transition team, but then also coming in as staff, we used to work with, you know, in the previous administration before the current administration. So I'm extremely excited for the leadership and the engagement and then the advocacy that I know HIMSS will be able to accomplish in the coming months and years.
Yeah, Tom and his team are a first-class team, and what they do is something. At times, we see what the process to get to a policy is a long way, and Tom's team, will push the, you know, here are our thoughts, but to get to those thoughts is at least 3 to 6 months, as you know.
Yes.
So what they have planned and the conversations they're having with the Biden administration will make this HIMSS membership very proud. I can tell you that.
Yeah. Excellent. So taking us a little bit of a step back, just around, because there's most of them, my ear, people that are in our earshot and that listen to the radio show are extremely familiar with HIMSS. But why don't we take a little bit of a step back and say, you know, why should people engage HIMSS, certainly the HIMSS annual conference? Let's go through some of the benefits. I mean, I can give my own testimonies, and I probably will certainly layer on because I've been part of HIMSS. I think I've gone to 21 HIMSS annual conferences in my short career. So I'm a committed long-term, lifetime member.
Oh, you?
But certainly, what are some of the things that that you would like to share with my audience and others?
You know, I think the one thing about with HIMSS, looking at how this year will be, whether it's hope for an in-person, plan for a digital, or plan for a hybrid event. One of the things that HIMSS does that we're really good at, thanks to the community, is to bring people together and spark conversation and learn from one another. And the way we learn from one another makes us individually better at what we do. I think that's one thing that HIMSS does, whether it's a digital experience, in person, or a hybrid event. We'll still bring that, and it's still evolving, that experience. We're a close group, even though we're closing in on close to 100,000 members. We should probably cross that point in 2021. We are a close-knit group. We all have similar experiences, similar challenges, and we come together and share those experiences, like I said earlier, to make ourselves better. We all have the same goal in mind. It's to transform or reform health information and technology. We want to make the world a better place. We all want to be the change.
Yeah. I love it. So I'll kind of layer on a little bit just from my experience. Yeah. And I was chairman of the EHR Association, and we tucked that actually under HIMSS kind of as a sister organization, but we worked very collaboratively with HIMSS, and HIMSS was phenomenal in supporting all of our endeavors through the years. And obviously the EHR Association is still a significant component to HIMSS. But one of the mantras that I always had was collaborate, learn, and lead is why I would go to HIMSS. I mean, I would never miss an annual conference, but also I collaborated with HIMSS and all of my industry peers on a weekly basis. I never went more than 3 days without having some board meeting or task force or work group that I participated in, because I would not only you're doing life with these people, you're building an industry, you're helping to lead an industry, but I am learning so much, and I'm learning so much about what's happening out there, best practices, how do I make myself better, how do I make my company better, my peers better, my industry, everybody, obviously providers, everybody in the organization and everybody in the industry. We all got better together. And that's one of my biggest testaments for why I will always be a lifetime and a lifelong member of the HIMSS organization, is just because of the forum that you afford the industry. And it's our job to take that and use that opportunity to benefit ourselves, benefit our communities, benefit our companies. And I promise you, if you do that, you'll be so much the wiser for it, for what you again bring back to yourself and your individual community and your company, but then also what you offer and what you serve into healthcare and health IT. So that's kind of my miniature testimony.
Well, Justin, I will circle back to you and have you join our testimonial campaign for 21. But I think you just capitalized on, or you just said some of the things we know we were taught in 20 was choices, flexibility, collaboration, and appreciation. Yeah. And that's what you get. That is sort of the crux of the HIMSS experience, so to speak, whether it's membership, engaging in one of our communities or events. It's the choice, how high of a level do you want to engage? How do you want to engage? The collaboration, the community, and the true appreciation we have for one another. I mean, going to global conference in person, the energy is amazing. I always get choked up the first day because it's just the swarms of people. And I found myself getting choked up on some of the digital events too at the beginning, because you can see the swarms of people online.
Yeah. So many familiar names too. And online you see the names, but when you kind of made me think to, my last HIMSS experience, when you step foot the first time on the show floor or into one of the conferences or even the hotel, to be honest, I live in Atlanta for the most part full time. And when I board that plane or even when I get to the gate, I already see 5 to 10 people that I know and that I've known probably for 20 to 25 years in healthcare and health IT and in the industry. So it gets exciting even when you walk up to the gate, never mind, or you're sitting down and you see 10 to 15 people that pass you in the aisle on the flight to Las Vegas or to Orlando. Those are the two main cities now, sometimes to Chicago. So, you know, that's when it really starts for me. But then certainly when you step foot in that show floor and you start, you know, you just see everybody. And to be honest, people that you love, that you've done life with for, you know, sometimes a quarter century, if not longer, in a lot of cases. And that's just cool. And then, you know, and then you just really kind of you settle in and you look to all to see that all you can accomplish over the next 3 to 4 to 5 days while you're there in that given city. And then it kind of, you know, it launches you to be the best you can be for the next year. So the next, you know, 9 months, the year or so. So it's cool.
Yeah, it's for where I sit, you know, as staff, and I'm usually locked away in the press room, but it's it's different to see how different reporters who have told this story, who have been our partners in telling the value and importance of health IT, to see how their careers have changed and to see how their storylines have changed. That's where we get excited, because you can see when it clicks, like, ah, I get it. And you see their fan clubs, I put that in air quote, that some of our press have. It's the same people come in and it's the big hug and it's the giggles and the laughs. And it's just that it's something I haven't seen in my, you know, or don't want to say lengthy career, but 20-year career, of the passion and the community that you see at HIMSS. And it's been exciting for us and encouraging for us as staff to see it carry through digitally, you know, in this remote world that we're living in right now. That passion still comes through. And there's still that appetite for more and more and more. So that's what has us smile, keeps us smiling.
Excellent. No, I love it. I couldn't agree more. So how have you guys modified operations, you know, over the past 7-8 months, you know, because you obviously have to modify HIMSS. You have to, you know, look at your operations, your strategy, but also, you know, maintain your position as a leader. But can you give us some insights of what you guys have discussed and what you've done over the past 9 months or so?
Well, 2020 was an exciting year for us and for a lot of people. I always tell folks that, you know, the pandemic would have been declared. Well, the pandemic was declared, which would have been the middle of global conference in Orlando.
Yeah.
And when you take that now away from it, you just realize that I can't even describe it to you, but it was paralyzing for me, paralyzing for my staff, because you just didn't know. And you were talking about people's personal safety. And when you get into that realm, the stress level goes up another level. One of the great things we have going for us at HIMSS is our leadership of our senior staff. You know, our president and CEO, Hal Wolf. I don't know if Hal's been on your show or not.
Yes. Yep.
Yep. We are an organization that was used to working remotely. So we have staff in Chicago. I, for example, am based here in Bethesda, Maryland. So we had the muscle memory to work remotely. We knew how to do it. So that was an advantage. And then under Hal's leadership, we just got really honest with what was working and what wasn't working. And more importantly, how we are going to support one another. Because not only did we have this pandemic raging out of our home offices, we had families, we had children going to school online, spouses losing jobs, changing jobs. There was a lot coming at it. So we really circled the wagons and became tight as a staff. Mm-hmm. We call it a bonding experience. And then we kept going on what we know we're good at. We know we're good at community building. We know we're good with our maturity models. We know you know, it's our digital presence. We kept on moving forward with what we're good at. And then we did a lot of listening. And with the pause of the pandemic and people not on airplanes, rushing to the next appointment, we had time to really dive in and really listen to each other, to our members, and really take that time for thoughtful, purposeful conversation. And we were overwhelmed with the compassion and the encouragement from our board down to our members, how they wanted to see us move forward.
That's phenomenal. That's just some great leadership skills there on how to lead an organization and how to keep your team inspired, collaborating, and you know, and leading to the next big thing. So that's excellent, Karen.
I can't tell you how many times though, Justin, we had, you know, it's one thing to be on a camera sitting at home in your home office. I can't tell you how many times we were on staff meetings or staff calls. We'd actually all sit there and cry, or encourage one another, or it's a softer, gentler world, at least where we are at HIMSS. We're humans.
Right.
And you know, one of the things we also learned is we were going through the action of 20. It was to be kind to ourselves, and that just carried out. No one's perfect. We're not perfect. I'm not perfect. But we learned a lot, and we're really looking forward to applying what we've endured into success for 21. All of us, the entire ecosystem that HIMSS is a part of.
Yep. So carrying on that, and what you guys have learned, and I know we talked about it a little bit, but if there's anything else that we can share to kind of let my audience know, and our communities know, you know, how do you guys see HIMSS21 or just HIMSS as an organization unfolding in the next couple of years, you know, offering more choice, greater flexibility, it comes to events and conferences. I know that we've already said, hey, we're hoping for, you know, we'll see how the annual conference shakes out for August. But how do you see HIMSS evolving, how they collaborate, if you do? I mean, and what are some of the, you know, changes that you might see or foreshadow HIMSS and all of your HIMSS constituency in the next year or two?
Well, so 2021 is the 60th anniversary of HIMSS.
Oh, wow. Yep, that's right.
And that, you know, you kind of think, what? You know, it's only HIMSS 21. You know, it's HIMSS has been around longer than 21 years. And it's that it's how this organization has endured and has listened and evolved to be a part of the community. So, you know, that High Tech Act, yep, when that came to play, that changed the world for us.
Yes.
And I think about how exciting it was. Another day like that will come. You know, one thing we've learned in the pandemic, it's put the spotlight on digital health and in the communities that we're all a part of. Now we know the importance of telehealth. We now know, and the world knows, the importance of electronic health records. Yeah. So, for as examples. Yeah. So now we need to start thinking about what's next. And that comes with listening. We will have some new products coming out and new services coming out closer to the middle of the year that our members have asked for, that the community has asked for, and are still in development. And they're being refined as we speak. But again, we took the advantage of the pandemic and listened and asked a lot of questions. And people were so generous with their time back. And that time, that pandemic, in a sense, that pause of the pandemic will make us better moving forward to the next 60 years. Digital health always will have to be here. You know, it's our responsibility as a community to take care of that, to foster it, and to grow it safely and successfully.
Yeah. No, that's excellent. So, in our closing minute or so, why don't we dive into you just a little bit personally? Because I can tell you're already going to be a frequent guest of the show. I know I'm going to have you back. There's so much to cover as healthcare, you know, continues to evolve this year, you know, continues to evolve. We're all, you know, waiting with bated breath to see how it actually does, see what this pandemic does and how we, you know, we evolve with it as a community and as an industry. So I know, you know, we'll have you back for sure to watch all this unfold with us and kind of give us the latest and greatest with the annual conference, because it's a big piece of a lot of our lives.
Yeah.
But in the final, you know, 30 seconds or so, getting to know you a little bit, too, and what inspires you? What is your favorite place to get or be inspired?
I am a water baby. Somewhere on the water, the lapping up of the bay, the ocean, the creek, just centers me and clears my mind and clears out that space for me to be creative. You know, what I do for a living has to have some creativity to it, and has to have a lot of transparency and purpose to what I do. So that I'm a water baby, so I need to be by the water.
That's excellent. So actually, that's usually my answer too. So, yeah. I grew up an hour from the water, but now have a place on the water in Florida. But that is where I go. And even here in Atlanta, had a place up a little north of us also on the water where it's just, that's where I clear my head, getting out on a boat or just being next to the water and having coffee over it in the morning, or just sitting and studying by it or reading by it, or, you know, just pontificating on life and everything that goes into it. That is where I clear my head. So I couldn't agree more. It's very, very similar to me. So, with that, Karen, you were a wonderful guest. I'm so happy you called
Thanks,
in
Justin.
And, we'll certainly have you back. And I know there's so much to cover regarding HIMSS, and we'll just stay in close speed with you on it.
So. I would love it, Justin. And remember, we got to keep hope alive. Hope, this is the year of hope.
You got it. You certainly have it from me. And I know you have it from most of my listeners, if not all, because we know what we're able to, you know, capable of as a country, as an industry, and we've always delivered, and we will continue to deliver. So there's always.
I agree with you 100%. Thank you so much for having me and giving me this opportunity.
You got it, Karen. We'll do it again. And thank you, everyone, for joining us today. And please tune in weekdays at 2:30 p.m. Eastern or 11:30 a.m. Pacific to hear our latest shows. You can always track me on Twitter at HIT Advisor and use the hashtag ThisJustinRadio so we can respond to your comments from the show. If you missed any of this episode or want to hear more, all my shows are posted on Apple iTunes, SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Spreaker, and TuneIn. Also, you can check out some of the updates that we've all launched at justinbarnes.com. Thanks, everyone. Have a terrific week and stay safe.